Okay, everyone, it's time for another installment of Forward Mythbusters. Today, we're taking on one of the most critical issues facing us right now, and that is the World Cup. So I'm pleased to be joined by Ali Backscheider, former collegiate soccer player, to help dispel some myths about the beautiful game. Ali, let's start with this. I just see a lot of people that just say soccer's dumb. They hate soccer. It seems to be their personality type. What do you say?
You know, that's a lame personality. Soccer, it's the most beautiful game. And hating it just means you haven't really watched it, that you haven't really sat down and enjoyed it. You know, I've witnessed people have their aha moments with soccer where they actually either go to a game. When you go to a game, really any level, like it can be a local club team, it can be really anything. Just seeing the crowd is amazing, and especially when you're in Europe. But I've been to a lot of women's soccer games, like U.S. women's national team in the States, and it's electric. It's so much fun. If hating it is your personality, it's kind of like how our finance director, Kate, would say, hating Taylor Swift is not your personality, which she's thrown at me. So,
yeah, I mean, name another sport where you go and you like sing and dance and jump up and down. Baseball? No, not really.
No. It's amazing. So, Mike, next one. You know, a lot of people call soccer socialist. What do you have to say about that?
Yeah, that's a real, it's a real popular dig. And I think socialist just means European, which is also funny because it's, you know, the most popular sport in the entire world. Yeah, they like to just call it socialist. I think this is funny for a couple of reasons. One is because socialist is just like a word that they use to like make fun of things they don't like. See point A about hating soccer, not being a personality type. But the second is like if you know the inner machinations of soccer teams and football clubs in Europe and so the way they manage the global aspect of the game is like they literally buy and sell players. Like, you know, American football, it's like, okay, well, these players are roughly equivalent in value, so we will swap them. And in soccer, Manchester United's like, I have $11 billion, please give me Ronaldo now. So, yeah. You know, like that's actually fairly capitalist, I would say, but none of that matters because like it's not defined by any political ideology. It's just a really awesome sport, so get over it.
Absolutely.
The third one that I love is people complaining that in fact these group stage games of the World Cup can end in ties. What say you?
Oh man. Well, first of all, the NFL and NHL can end in ties, so screw anybody who says it's the most boring sport ever because it can end in ties. Second, I get it. Everybody loves to see goals scored. That's super fun. But it just makes it that much more special when there is a close game and there is that goal. And also, when I was playing at Butler, the games that ended in a tie were some of the most fun. Very frustrating, but just such good competition. You're so even. And it's, I don't know. Ending in a tie is not as boring as everybody thinks. That just means, you know, watch a few more games and you'll understand why it's very special when a goal is actually scored.
Yeah, and they won't be ending in ties after the games in the group stage. You know, the World Cup final will not end in a tie.
No, exactly. And like, you know, there's always, it depends on what league you're watching or whatever, but like there's nothing better than golden goal in overtime and, you know, penalty kicks. It's just, you know, it's riveting. So stick with it. all right. So let's talk about, you know, the game today. You know, everybody's rooting for random sports every 4 years in the Olympics, like curling. So, you know, why should people be cheering for the U.S. men's national team to beat Iran today?
Yeah, I mean, I find it funny that people are like, oh, I don't care about the World Cup, not a big deal. And then, like, the Olympics come around, and we're all, like, glued to our TV watching swimming, a sport we never watch the rest of the time, watching archery. I love watching Olympic archery, even though I have never watched archery outside of the Olympics. It's fun. It's cool. Part of it is rooting for your country. And guess what? The World Cup, even though there is soccer in the Olympics, the World Cup is really the Olympics of soccer. And so this is your chance. Stand up for your country. Do it for the badge, as they say. Wave your America kit. And let's root for America to beat Iran and to progress out of the group stage so that they have a chance to win the World Cup. Still probably not odds on favorites. But you know what? As long as you make the playoffs, you've got a chance. So Let's go, America. Rally the flags. Get behind it. Even if you don't like soccer and never want to watch it the rest of the time, that's okay. But cheer for America today.
Yeah. I believe that we will win.
I believe that we will win. All right. Let's get them.
Love it.